Hello everybody. So today we're looking at how to get select option values in Scrapy using Python. Then I'll also show you how to do it with Beautiful Soup just for completeness. So what we've got is an example using XPath on a Stack Overflow response. What they've said is use response.xpath with select option text, which is fine. But what that actually will do is that will get all of the values for all of the dropdowns on a page. So if you've got a website like this, for instance, Zoopla, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, at least 4 dropdowns that we can see straight away. So, and I've already done inspect, so you can see the option values. We can see, let me just click off that. You can see the select ID. Remember the select ID for sale underscore price max, price underscore max. So let's just copy that, cut it rather. I always just cut because, you know you've got it then. So fetch, I'm in Scrapy shell. Refer back to previous videos if you're not familiar with that. So fetch zoopla.co.uk. And then we just need to do the following. So what we do is instead of response.xpath, then we'll do single quotes on the outside, and then we'll do 2 forward slashes, which is quite common because that's taking you to the current level in the DOM rather than right from the top of the tree. And then we will do something like this. So we would do select. Well, let me show you the option select option text. And wow. So that looks like an overwhelming amount of information. So if we do, let's just do get to start with. Okay, it says no min. So that's got the first value out of probably all 4. And there we go. That's we've got PCM, so that's got the calendar month, rental values, and so on. So you get the idea. It's actually getting us way too much. So what we'll do is instead of this, we will go keep the element as select, and then we will do at ID equals, and then I'm gonna have to see if I can still paste. Yeah. And we've got an error, so how are we going to fix that? I think that's probably because of that. And there we go. So, my little error there was just that I forgot to put the slash in there. So, as always with XPaths, response.xpath, so that's the Scrapy response object. I use single quotes on the outside and double quotes on the inside, but you could do the opposite and it would still work as long as they're different. So yeah, select at ID, without using that, we got all of this, which was way too much and that's no use to anybody. So you see the difference, select option text, and then we went select at ID equals. So that's the only difference, we've used the predicate. So you see the square bracket, start square bracket, end square bracket. That is what it filters out all of the other stuff that you don't want, and it just gets you the contents of that ID. So there you've got a load of values as a list, and potentially you might want to convert them to numeric values, in which case you would use replace strip. You would replace the pound sign with nothing, and you'd remove the commas, and then you would convert the string to an integer. So there we go, that's the one for Scrapy. So let's look at Beautiful Soup. Okay, so drop downs in Beautiful Soup. So we'll do from BS4 import beautiful soup import requests, then we'll say something like my page, which I've actually saved the page offline because I don't want to hammer the website whilst I'm testing, it and potentially getting errors and then end up getting blocked. So I'm just going to paste that in there. So what I've done is I just went to the site and I just did right click and save page, just in the browser. So let's just save that. Let me please save. So BS4 drop down X example.py. Okay. This is just a German property website with a drop down. It's quite a long URL. So next we say soup equals beautiful soup. When you're doing it locally, you don't need to use requests. So that was force of habit. Open my page, and we'll use LXML because it's faster. And have I got a close quote missing? No, I had an extra bracket in there. Parentheses rather. Soup equals soup dot find. Now this is the important bit, because what you're doing is you're actually going to just isolate the content within the div where the class equals. Select input wrapper. Okay, so here we go. I forgot what. Okay, so what I was actually scraping was the drop down. There's nothing showing there because it's loaded by JavaScript. What I wanted was the values from the drop down here, because that will then tell me how many times I have to iterate through looking for the next page. So if we can see, we've got 127 here. So how do we get 127 from that drop down? And that is where we use right click inspect and div class select dash input dash wrapper. And as you can see, if I just scroll down, just keep an eye on those numbers. Okay, 127, there we go. So back to beautiful soup and select input wrapper. Okay, and then what do we want next? We want to say that items equals soup dot select. And this is probably something which you won't use very often if you're not, well, you won't use at all if you're not ever passing values, so drop down values. Select option and then value inside the square bracket. Then we say values equals, and this is where we use item.get. Item.get. We use item.get because it stops us getting an error if there's nothing found for item in items. So we've got all of our items in a list, and this will run. Yeah, but what we need to do is convert that text into int. So int item for item in values. In our values list, we just turn all of those items into integers, and then that should run okay. Yeah, and then we just do print x, and that should just give us 0 to 127, and there we go. Oh, not 0, so it's 1. Yeah, of course, because we're just finding the it's not like a normal list where it starts from 0, it's actually finding the option values. So soup, The key thing to learn from this or remember is to use soup.select, not find all, but soup.select. Yeah? And if I remember that in a week's time, then that'll be a surprise. That's why I do these videos. Thumbs up and all that, yeah?